In requesting the Elemental's assistance to find your stola, you must needs be aware of one difficulty. A difficulty born of the fundamental difference between man and Elemental.
That being...
In perceiving the world around him, man relies upon senses such as sight and sound. For the sake of convenience, he gives names to such things as are near or dear to him. Being formed of pure ether, however, such concepts are foreign to the elementals. Instead, they perceive by observing the ebb and flow of the energies of life. So profound a division cannot be bridged with simple discourse. The elementals' voices stir not the air, and thus reach not our ears, while our words are but wind to them. Though we seers can commune with them through feelings, naught that we can impart will serve to aid them in identifying Ishtola. Nay, they must needs be presented with ether which is akin to hers. If you could but find a family member.
Oh! I know just the person! Ishtola has a sister who came to live in Gridania. She told me about her once.
Oh, that is most fortunate indeed. Pray, seek this sister out then, and bring her to Evershade. There, we shall petition the Great One's aid in finding your lost companion.
Thank you.
let us begin. Raya O, Arun, if you would. Hearken to me, O great ones. Pray, give yourselves to the Lifestream, a drifting soul to find.
Please, Ystola, please come back to us.
There. Now. A room has been readied at the roost. Pray, bear her thither at once. All that remains is to pray, my friends.
You stole her! I'm so glad you're back!
Tataru. You are safe. Thank the 12. Something has changed about you, Alphinaud. Or mayhap the change is with me. I seem to sense the ether around me more keenly than before.
I am pleased to see you well again. Do you feel strong enough to talk?
Worry not. I am well enough.
Tell us then, what befell you after you fled the feast? We were told that there had been a tunnel collapse.
That was my doing. I brought the tunnel down that you and Minfilia might escape. At the last moment, I invoked a teleportation magic, in hopes of spiriting Thancred away at least. Needless to say, it did not go quite as planned, and I found myself adrift in the Lifestream. The others? Where are they? Did they not escape?
They remain unaccounted for. You were the only one we have been able to find. I am truly sorry. It was the Crystal Braves who pursued you that day. My hubris that led to our undoing.
No apologies are necessary, Alphinaud. You are not to blame for what occurred. Know that were our comrades here, they would commend you for keeping the light of hope alive.
Don't worry. The others are alive and well, I'm sure of it. We just need to find them.
Indeed, Tataru. Let us find our friends and rebuild the Scions.
Ha! There is the Alphinaud I remember. And I feel much the better for his return. 'Tis time I arose.
That reminds me! I have a change of clothes for you! I don't like to boast, but I made them myself. I learned how to weave while we're in Ishgard, you see.
Tataru has apprised me of all that took place in the aftermath of the assassination plot. It would seem I have been away for some while.
Yes, much and more happened during your absence. At present, we seek to follow the Archbishop to Azislar.
And you want for some manner of etheric ram to pierce the floating isle's protective barrier?
We do. Might you be able to furnish us with one?
A means to prise open a hole in an Alagarn barrier. And one large enough to admit an airship, no less. Nay, I lack the knowledge to devise such a weapon. But I know of one who could. A leading figure in the field of etheric research, and one of the finest scholars ever to grace Sharlion. Matoya, my former master.